For fathers across North America, today was full of tributes. But for thousands of migrant families torn apart by U.S. border officials, today was just another day of anguish. President Trump is expected to discuss his controversial zero-tolerance policy on illegal immigration on Tuesday. But as Paul Hunter reports, today, opposing voices only grew louder.
What do we want? Justice!
It's being called inhumane, un-American, soulless, and the fury has been building for weeks. Today, marching on ad hoc detention centers for the children of illegal migrants, this one outside El Paso.
I don't care where you are on the spectrum as far as immigration is concerned. Separating children from their parents is not the way to go. That is never an acceptable answer.
This one in McAllen, Texas, where more than 1,000 young boys are now housed in a converted Walmart.
Under no moral code and under no religious tradition is this acceptable.
You are not forgotten.
And this demonstration in faraway New Jersey.
The Trump administration has announced a zero tolerance policy that has zero morality, zero decency, zero integrity, and we will not rest until we shut that policy down.
Zero tolerance means U.S. authorities now prosecute all illegal migrants criminally. Under U.S. law, the children of parents facing such prosecution are taken into government custody. But it's Donald Trump's decision to prosecute, tearing apart families, that's angered so many. Last week, Trump tried to deflect blame.
Mr. President, do you agree with children being taken away from
the border? No, I hate it. I hate the children being taken away. The Democrats have to change their law. That's their law.
But that's not quite true. While irregular border crossings were illegal before Trump, there's no law that requires this kind of hardline approach. And yet, said White House Counselor Kellyanne Conway today,
I will tell you that nobody likes this policy. You saw the president on camera that he wants this to end.
U.S. authorities say some 2,000 children have been separated from their families in this way from mid-April to the end of May. And as the fury over that continues, that number grows ever larger. Paul Hunter, CBC News, Washington.
As debate rages over the morality of all this, it is worth looking at what those kids face after they're separated from their parents. What do those youth migrant shelters look like, and what happens inside them?
Were you scared to come to the United States?
Ha venido a los Estados Unidos.
Sí.
Looming largest, of course, the pain of separation. But U.S. officials say life inside the shelters themselves is vastly better than facing the perils of the desert. They maintain the children get the same food as U.S. public students get. They go to school and play outside. They are allowed just 2 phone calls a week. And those who have seen inside tell some troubling tales about what else happens. Antar Davidson, a former shelter worker in Arizona, is now speaking out.
A 16-year-old boy, a 10-year-old girl, and an 8-year-old boy, they were told that they were going to separate. And when I arrived to the scene, The 2 younger siblings were grasping the brother and desperately trying to hold on to them. They were all just tearing, you know, weeping. And I said to the brother, I said, you know, in Portuguese, I said, you know, try and be strong. I know it's a hard time. He looks at me with tears streaming down his face and says, how? And then it was at that time that a shift leader ran up to me and told me very aggressively, diles que no pueden abrazar. Tell them that they can't hug. Tell them they can't hug. And I said to her at that point, I said, listen, you know, morally as a human being, I can't do that.
Davidson says among the biggest issues, at least at his facility, experience and training. More pointedly, many shelter workers hardly had any training at all.
Workers received 1 week of training. Most people had been in construction or restaurants. So they had, and there were very few people. They were always trying to hire people. So they were already ill-prepared to deal with a compliant population.
So what's the answer? What would Davidson tell the American public? So
my message to the American public is we call for more transparency, specifically to Attorney General Jeff Sessions and President Donald Trump. The way we're doing it now is not working, and we need more transparency, and we need to do something about this.
And Southwest Key, the nonprofit that runs the facility where Davidson worked, has spoken out since he went public. Its vice president says it takes training its workers seriously and that it cares greatly about the welfare of the kids in its care.